Alright, you've seen it, let's go.
You're joking. You're serious?
Well...
What are you?
Portia.
I'm looking for clues. Tips.
Yes.
Leads.
None here.
It's not exactly...
No.
Forthcoming.
Forthcoming.
This room.
No.
You're strange, Todd.
I'm not. Not at all.
What's behind those doors?
Another apartment. Neighbors.
Really?
A railroad flat. Tenement.
Curious smell.
The neighbors?
Food becomes flesh somehow, you know?
Of course.
Well, you know those people who trap cooking odors in their hair, in their down vests, in their all over themselves?
They're sloppy people, the neighbors.
Do you know that?
We've never met.
They must be sloppy people.
Yes.
This isn't what I expected, I must say.
What did you
Something
expect?
Something cleaner, more pared down, geometric somehow. I don't know, I can't say, but not this, I don't know, house of Usher. Do you like living here?
Sometimes.
The walls feel like predators. They roam and idle, grow mouths and tongues, close in and bare their teeth. This is what loneliness is to me.
Living beasts.
I've noticed you quote from yourself an awful lot.
What?
That, just then. That was a quotation, wasn't it?
Yes.
From this book of ours, wasn't it?
Yes.
Well, of course I'd realize that, wouldn't I?
Yes, look, why...
I've also noticed that, in general, when you're not quoting from yourself, your conversation tends toward the...
Toward the...
Bland.
The bland, yes.
You're not one of our glib authors.
Perhaps. Not.
You're beautiful, though.
So are you.
And you write like an angel. How do you write so beautifully?
My writing...
Yes?
It burns in the smithy... of my smithy.
Torment! I love it! Beauty and pain! What parlay? Tell me the truth. Those aren't the neighbors behind those doors. Behind those doors, there's some horribly twisted gnome who does all of your writing for you!
Oh, you've had too much to drink tonight!
Celebrating
what?
Us, this teaming, this partnership. Success is absolutely assured. No, Todd, I want you to know that. The pages you've shown us, God, they're incredible. And the jacket photograph alone will be a classic. No, I'm sincere. I think you have something important to contribute to literature.
Thank you.
Why are you so nervous?
I'm embarrassed by the smell.
I don't mind.
It embarrasses me.
I think it's sexy.
It's not.
It is. No. I swear.
Tonight, it's not.
You want me to go.
You've noticed.
You're the fever type.
A little.
And tomorrow you must rise early and have your chog and your protein shake and then spill your pain at the typewriter. Hours and hours wiggling the loosened tooth of your despair.
I guess.
I'm sorry I invaded your territory. I needed to see, though. I'm not one of those casual editors. I can't just tighten your syntax. I needed to see, to know, to absorb, to live through, to live with, to contemplate, to understand. To understand. Good night.
Ha ha ha! You balked.
This is wonderful, is it?
The moment came, the decisive moment, and you let it slip by. That's unforgivable.
Pain! The sheer pain! Oh, it's painful!
Because of me?
I'll send this off first thing tomorrow. Portia will think she inspired me. Will she like it?
What?
The chapter.
Oh, yes.
You're sure?
I'm sure.
Because I can't tell.
I'm sure.
Because I don't see how.
I'm sure!
Touchy, touchy, touchy.
She was beautiful tonight, wasn't she?
Who?
The girl.
Which?
Tonight.
Portia.
Yes.
Yes? I think so. Yes.
You think so?
I wasn't paying close attention. These things repeat themselves.
You appall me!
She was beautiful.
I saw.
What?
There's a keyhole, you know. I slid beneath the door, slanted light, the room made visible. I moved, I watched.
Son of a bitch!
Not the whole picture, but hair and calves and
ankles.
Son of a
bitch!
I think an elbow.
I told you not to move when she was here. I told you to act like a church mouse.
I am a church mouse.
She was curious enough without hearing sounds.
She was curious and you nipped
that. Don't you know how fragile this whole deal is?
Is it the neighbors?
She can't find out about this, Gene. Or it's all over. We're through.
Such a bad thing.
Again, please, not again. That damned... What is it called when you say something over and over?
Litany.
That damn litany! Over and over! Yes, it would be a bad thing. What we have is a good thing. If it ended, it would be a bad thing.
Not for me.
Oh, please.
Despised, sequestered, denied even the standard compensations I would relish.
Do you want me to put you back where I found you?
No.
In the gutter.
In the gutter? What a cliche. I was in an alley.
Crying and starving.
And carrying pages of precious material which you promised.
I took you in.
You took me for everything I had. It was not Nightingale in the Crimea.
I took the pages to a party. Could you have done that? I met Portia there. Could you have done that? She said, this is a work of, this is a work of...
genius.
Genius, yes! I let her take me to lunch. I worked my charm. I finessed her into a contract.
Thus began my stellar career.
And it's good! That sort of thing has got to stop.
Why did you let her go tonight?
I wasn't interested.
How could you not be interested?
These things repeat themselves.
They
get dull. My libido wavers.
Mine!
I'm going to bed.
Why don't you ever bring anyone home? Sometimes you don't come home yourself. I
wait. I sit. I don't move. It hurts to move anyway. My body is sore. My muscles ache from disuse and misshapenness. I sit in that patch of darkness that's been allotted to me, that cupboard, and I stare out at an air shaft waiting for someone to come, something to happen for you, and you don't come. Why don't you bring them home? I'd be so grateful. I just want to see it live and unrehearsed. I'd be so grateful.
Please stop talking and go to sleep before I say something true that will hurt you.
I wash hour after hour. I'm The smell comes from airlessness, from being alone with myself in a dark place. Let me out and it will go away.
You don't want to go out.
You don't let me.
Don't you dare.
just for a stroll of a walk on the street. I need books. If I have to live in a truly verbal universe, I must have my vocabulary replenished every now and then. Just let me onto my books and I'll come right back and be happy.
I get you whatever books you need. You know that.
I need to see people walking on the street.
No fits tonight. I'm too tired.
My needs are not being attended.
You don't want to walk. You know you don't. You know it.
Just for an afternoon.
They laugh at you on the street.
Not always.
Mostly they do.
Mostly they do.
I'm not offended.
The higher-ups simply think, and in a way I agree with them, they simply think, oh, here, hold this. They simply think the book as it stands is a little spineless, that's all. Oh.
Spineless?
Lacking a spine.
Ah.
The quality of the word, of the feeling, of the emotional milieu is immaculately rendered. But right now there seems to be no thrust. No action, no event. Right now it's sort of lumpy, sort of puddingy, a kind of mousse of despair. Not that that's bad. We're all agreed that despair is due for a revival. We're simply suggesting you incorporate more of the, you know, you make it less endoscopic, if you know what I pose.
I don't know if I can do that.
Oh, Todd.
What does that mean? Oh, Todd.
I know your nightlife.
That's irrelevant.
It's superficial, not irrelevant.
I could never possibly write that.
Hold this.
These are grotesque.
They're just jacket ideas, they're not the real thing.
Do I look like that?
Of course not.
How do I look?
Nice.
I mean, how do I look to you?
Like Todd.
Portia?
Todd.
Please get off of me.
Aren't you attracted to me?
I don't remember.
What?
I sometimes empty out.
What?
I can't muster enthusiasm. I forget. My body remembers, but I forget.
Is that... what is that? Some sort of Zen code or something? What is that?
Please.
What is with you, Todd?
Portia.
Oh, Todd, don't hide from me. There's no need. Don't you know there's nothing about you too dark, too hideous? No single thing about you too ugly for me to accept, embrace, and love.
I need to do rewrites.
It's come over you?
Yes. What?
Inspiration.
Yes.
I'll go. Now remember, a story, a spy, facts. Bring in your club days, bring in your sex life. Make me a book I can sell.
Yes.
Wait a second.
What?
Have the neighbors moved?
Why?
The smell's gone.
Jean. Jean! Glasses and looked hardly normal at all. I was careful, Todd. Don't look at me like that. I was so careful. No one saw. Not the neighbors, not the super, no one. I walked in the shadows exclusively. I know you've taken me on a great personal and financial sacrifice to yourself. I know I've altered your life completely. I know that with me on your hands, no sane life is possible at all. I know. I'm grateful. I truly am. I'm not an ingrate. Don't look at me like that! I got these while I was out from a used bookstore, swearing as musty as myself, I fit right in. I had to do this, Todd, for the both of us. Words were losing their attachments without this one-time-only trip. You would have had a book full of nonsense, a mere crunch of syllables. It's not a place I want to go to anymore in the world. This isn't fair! Look. Burn this greatcoat, and buy another on our royalties, and another hat too, and more glasses. I know I'm in the fetch, and I won't be insulted. Please, just talk. I'm sure I must have been laughed at on the street. You don't have to worry. Todd.
Come here.
Why?
Come here.
Why?
Because I want to hold you.
Todd.
Please. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you. Please come out. Please come out. I'm not a cruel person. I'm not.
Jean?
Jean. Are you alright now? Are you better? You sound better. Jean, listen. I'm gonna do like we used to, okay? Remember? I'm gonna tell you something that happened to me, and you can tell me what it means. Remember? Okay? Is that okay? Okay. This happened the other day at the health club. You know where I go. Right, well, I was going to take a swim. I had never used the pool there before, but I wanted to swim. So I was getting ready when a man at the row of lockers across from me started talking to his friend. This man, he was balding. But he seemed pretty fit, and he was pleased with himself. You could tell, like, he didn't even mind being bald. And I thought, if I feel like that at his age, I won't be doing half bad. And his friend looked pretty good, too, and it sort of cheered me up. Anyway, they finished getting ready, and I went to the pool, and they went to the pool, and then I went to the pool. It was just the three of us, and the attendant. The attendant yelled at me, "No trunks!" I didn't understand. Then I looked at the two men swimming in the pool. They were naked. It was policy. When they were naked like that, they didn't look so good. They looked fat. They looked like fish. Large, extinct fish. I bent down to take off my trunks. As I did, the bald man came up for air. For a second, he was completely still, frozen solid in the water. He looked at me and kept looking. I dove in, a perfect dive with a flip and a spin. When I came up for air, the bald man wasn't in the pool anymore. He was standing by the poolside, crying hysterically. His friend was next to him, trying to calm him down. "Why are you crying?" he kept asking. "It was the dive," he said. "It was the dive." Jean? Jean, why did that make him cry? Why? Why did that make him cry? Jean, why?
Because it was sad!
Ah. I need you to tell me these sorts of things, Jean. I can't figure them out on my own. My life isn't good. You think it is, but it's not. Once it was, but it's not anymore. I used to be made happy by stupid things. Looking in the mirror. I looked so hard, I didn't recognize myself. I got scared, Jean. I didn't know where I was half the time. And then I found you. Make me famous, Jean. I want to be famous. They'll photograph me and write about me, and I'll study how they see me, and I'll learn to live in it, and it'll be like a home. I'll give you anything you want. I won't deny you anymore. Anything I can, I'll give you.
scene must be played out perfectly.
I don't know if I can do this.
You will do it. I'll stop writing if you don't. I'll go back to the streets, find another benefactor, or die!
Right? But what do I say? It's been a long time.
I'll write the scene, you simply play it out. You come up behind Portia.
Yes.
Fling an arm across her chest.
That's melodramatic.
You fling an arm across her chest.
All right, fine.
Then you say, "Darling, I want you."
I say what?
"Darling, I want you."
I don't say that.
You do.
You're crazy.
"Darling, I want you."
She'll laugh in my face.
Never.
The only words I could possibly get away with in that whole sentence are "I" and "you."
You will say it. You'll say, "Darling, I want you," and she'll be moved by the poetic simplicity of your expression.
Fine.
Okay. Then you turn her towards you, kiss each shoulder, her neck, then rise ever so slowly till your lips meet hers. Then say, "Be mine." And then...
Wait.
What?
That won't work.
It'll work like a dream.
Trust me on this.
Like a dream.
She will be out of here in 14 seconds flat.
Nonsense.
I promise you.
Nonsense.
I promise you.
Then what would you say? What do you say in a situation like this? There's a woman, there's a bed, you're alone, you're enchanted. What do you say?
Do you want to sleep with me?
Oh.
I'm sorry.
You don't understand.
I do.
You don't understand the situation.
Inform me.
You are enraptured. You are transported. This is no common lay. This is no cheap one-nighter. The very fiber of your being quivers in expectancy. Poetry floods your soul. Do you want to sleep with me? Simply will not suffice, not this night. So then, what do you say when all the beauty of the universe turns inside you?
Are you staying?
Oh. You will do what I say. You will say, "Darling, I want you." You will say, "Be mine." You will be tender and slow and romantic. You will make it work.
Not a sound from you.
Yes, I know.
Not a peep.
I promise.
For your good as well as mine. You know I act for both of us, don't you? You know I want what's best for both of us.
Yes.
I'll be back soon.
God. It wouldn't be so bad if she saw me. Not so bad. Oftentimes, beautiful women come upon hideous men and fall in love with them. They uncover a hidden beauty and, oh, crowns of light form canopies over their head. And the carbuncles and the cicatrices, the humps and wens, they disappear. The beasts are replaced by angels. She'll see me, Todd. She'll see. And you will be loved for me.
Lights and your face came floating up at me in patches. It was poetry, truly poetry. I was speaking to new boys today, Todd. They want to take you to lunch. They're very excited, really thrilled. Everything's mapped out, your whole itinerary. The book jacket's designed, display cases are ready, and we're putting your face on billboards all over the city. All we need now is a book.
I'm working slowly.
No matter, I have faith in you. I believe in you. This night has been sensational. You actually invited me in. Todd.
Darling, I want you.
What?
Darling, I want you.
Could you shrug at these? Thank you. Now, be careful. I'm getting my period. I'm a little bit sensitive.
Wait!
I know this is not the best time to start some sort of blazing romance, but you are so damn slow!
Be mine!
Christ, Todd, where are you getting these lines from? Come on!
Wait!
I think most people would think it's going pretty well.
Don't understand.
What?
Turn around.
Todd.
Turn around. Be mine.
Do you want to sleep with me?
You're doing everything wrong.
Am I staying?
Portia.
What are you talking about?
It's supposed to be beautiful.
Kiss me. And I stand tall. You don't know your part at all.